Kristen Gaspar is chairperson of the San Diego Board of Supervisors. She'll be voting against California sanctuary law and joins us to weigh in. Kristen, can you give us an idea what the effect is since Governor Jerry Brown says, I know more than the country. I know what's best for California. I want to make this a sanctuary state.
I'm going to provide you a visual this morning because this is my third term in elected office, and never have I seen correspondence quite like on this issue. So, for example, I want to show you the number of people who have weighed in, this thin stack, that support Governor Brown's actions on sanctuary state. Now I want to share with you something quite interesting. The number of people that have communicated with me in San Diego County, the people who do not support moving forward with Governor Brown's sanctuary state. This is really quite remarkable. The pouring in of hundreds and hundreds of emails, and this only includes items that have come through the regular email inbox. That doesn't include the phone calls that I've received and anything on social media. It's really remarkable.
Wow. So the governor didn't like the federal laws, so he passed these state laws, and you have cities and counties that are saying it's unconstitutional. Why do you think you finally said enough is enough in California, or several counties and cities are speaking out?
I think San Diegans are finally waking up, finally seeing and saying enough is enough, Governor Brown, because in San Diego County, we manage a $5.7 billion budget on the County Board of Supervisors. Only $1.7 billion is in our direct control. The rest are decisions being made by the state and the federal government. These are oftentimes harmful decisions that are impacting San Diegans. Governor Brown needs to follow the laws of our Constitution.
So what I've noticed too, I was in the Los Angeles Orange County area, I could not believe the level of homeless. People are coming in here, setting up tents, not even trying to get involved in society. And now I understand they're looking at public lands to set up these homes for the homeless, since they're all coming here in many cases illegally. What have you seen in San Diego? What has been the effect of the people there?
Well, when you think back to 9/11, all of the rhetoric was about how important it was for coordination to take place between local, state, and federal government. Well, we've done that in San Diego. We had a system in place. We had task forces in place, for example, to stop maritime issues that we were having of humans, drugs, and weapons being smuggled into the United States, right here into San Diego. Unfortunately, under SB 54, our local law enforcement can no longer take part in those maritime task forces to cut down on human trafficking, drug trafficking, weapons trafficking across the border. It's really quite unfortunate, the impacts of SB 54.
So today you're meeting, is it, who's meeting today? Is it your county board? Who makes the decision today?
The County Board of Supervisors is meeting at 9 a.m. this morning. There's an open session item where people can make comments on the agenda. The County Board will then adjourn into closed session because I haven't asked our board to write a meaningless resolution. Rather, I have asked our board to explore any and all legal options that we have at this point. So the council will be meeting with the County Board, and we will be discussing how the county can move forward and push back against Governor Brown's unconstitutional actions.
And Chris, are you doing this on your own? Are you going to join the government's lawsuit?
We're hoping that we might be able to join in the government's lawsuit. We're not sure about the deadlines. That's why it's really important that we have our competent legal team there to assist us and address any solutions that might be on the table.
And lastly, the wall worked in San Diego, didn't it?
The wall did work in San Diego County. We have seen that cut down on the drug trafficking, on the weapons trafficking, and human trafficking is something that we're really focused on now. The human sex trade trafficking that's coming across the border is really unfortunate. We need the coordination between local, state, and federal agencies in order to make San Diego a safe place.
All right. Kristen Gaspar, thank you so much for joining us, Kristen.
Thank you.
I look forward to getting the results of that vote. Meanwhile, straight ahead. The cold blood.